Hi, welcome back to Daughters of the King. I am Kathryn Gore, and tonight we are going to talk about Jehovah Rohi. Let's get right into scripture here. Let's start with Isaiah 53, verse 4. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him. And by his wounds we were healed, or we are healed, excuse me. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Who am I speaking of? Who could this be? Who took up our pain and bore our suffering? Who was pierced for our transgressions and crushed for our iniquities? Who carried our grossly unfair behavior? Who carried our wickedness, sinfulness, immorality, evil, sin, criminality? This is all what iniquity wraps up to be. Foulness, dreadfulness, ungodliness, crime, wrongdoing, offense. Who carried this? Jehovah Rohi. The Lord is my shepherd. And this is what we're going to be talking about tonight. We're going to talk about the good shepherd. Psalms 23 says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters, and he refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Now the Lord protects, provides, directs, leads, and cares for his people. God tenderly takes care of us as a strong and patient shepherd. You're going to hear me say that statement a couple more times within this message. Now let's talk about an earthly shepherd. An earthly shepherd is responsible to protect the sheep, just as the Lord Jehovah Rohi is. Now in Isaiah 53 verse 6, it stated, "We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each one of us has turned to our own way." And I started thinking about this and I said, you know, what would make a sheep go astray? And in doing research, I found that after sheep eat, they just wander off. At times, they just wander off as if they have no clue that they have left the herd, they left the flock, and now they are wandering off, not realizing they can fall in a ditch, break a leg, they can be injured, they can even become attacked by a predator. They have left themselves vulnerable to receive attention outside of the flock. Don't we do this at times? You know, I started thinking about the word eating, and I was thinking, okay, food can do a lot of things for us, right? I was thinking about the word eat, and you know, I'm thinking, okay, food, they're eating food. And I know that food at times can satisfy us, right? It can bring us fulfillment and pleasure. And I started thinking, you know, at times I can see why we are related to sheep, because at times when we are satisfied, okay, when we have some type of pleasure, we forget and wander off away from the sheep, away from the herd. It's almost as if we are so satisfied and fulfilled that it's like, I'm good. I don't need to stay in this area. I'm just going to go over here real quick and I'm good. And you know, that gets us in trouble. But Jesus, Jehovah Rohi, is the good shepherd. Now, some of the predators that attack the sheep, they can range in wolves, coyotes, mountain lions, bears, domestic dogs, you know, things like that. And the shepherd can use guard dogs or other animals to protect the sheep. At times, they may use rifles to shoot the predator who is attacking the sheep. And I started thinking about this. Okay, so the shepherd has his special tools, which is like the guard dogs or other guard animals, and he has his guns. And I started thinking, okay, the Lord has his holy angels, he has his Holy Spirit, he has his power and authority. And I started to really process this in regards to how an earthly shepherd protects the flock and how the Lord Jehovah Rohi protects his flock. Now, when we read in scripture, you know, the word talks to us about the wolves and how we have to be very careful about them. Now, Jehovah Rohi, he again is the good shepherd. And listen to how he talks to the Pharisees in John 10. He explains how he's the good shepherd. And anyone who tries to come into the fold any other way is a thief. So John 10 says, "Very truly, I tell you, Pharisees," the Pharisees have been in the atmosphere lately. I don't know what is going on, but this is where God is at. He's talking to or about people like the Pharisees. And he says, "Very truly, I tell you, Pharisees, anyone who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way is a thief and a robber. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him because they do not recognize a stranger's voice." Jesus used a figure of speech, but the Pharisees did not understand what he was telling them. "Therefore," Jesus said, "very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who have come before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep have not listened to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full." Now, an earthly shepherd can only do so much to protect his flock. He can use guard dogs and guns, but Jesus, being a good shepherd, gave his life for his sheep. John 10 verse 11 says, "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that are not of this sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd." Now, who is this other sheep that the Lord must bring in also? Right now he's talking to the Pharisees, he's talking to the Jews, and he's saying, you know, "I have another sheep. I have other sheep that are not of this sheep pen, but they must come with me and they will listen to me too." Those sheep would be the Gentiles. And, you know, he's talking about how he wants to bring the Jews and the Gentiles together and have one flock and one shepherd, which is him, over that flock. Now, Jesus kept saying, I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me. Now, listen to how this works in Matthew 4:18. Jesus calls his first disciples. 18 says, as Jesus was walking beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon called Peter and his brother Andrew. They were casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. Come follow me, Jesus said, and I will send you out to fish for people. At once they left their nets and followed him. Going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, preparing their nets. Jesus caught them, and immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. So, you know, I always found it to be interesting when I read this scripture. How is it that these men that just met Jesus, they just met him? Like, Jesus is just like walking by the sea, and he sees these four men, and he looks at them at different times and says, come, follow me. And they drop everything. Let's go back to John 10. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. Now, John 17 gives us insight in regards to how they're able to drop everything and just know. They just know. You know, Jesus meets them for the first time walking on the Sea of Galilee. He says, come, follow me. They left their father. They left their boat. They left their nets. They just left everything, their normal life, and followed Jesus. Now, John 17 says, and this is Jesus praying to the Father. He said, I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours. You gave them to me, and they have obeyed your word. You know, I find this to be very interesting because Jesus knew exactly who was going to follow him because he was so close to the Father and understood that these people, like his disciples, they were first God's. And then God gave them and whoever else followed Jesus, gave these people to Jesus, and Jesus knew instantly who they were by name. By name. This is how close we need to be with the Father. Jesus knew immediately and has so much authority and so much power and anointing on him. As soon as these disciples saw him, he knew them. They knew him. They may not understood it, but they knew him. He said, no other voice will they follow. My sheep know me, and I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. Just like I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. He didn't have to do too much. He came on the scene and said, come follow me, and they just knew. And he knew. I find this to be so, so amazing. Now, going back to an earthly shepherd, is also, I don't know if you know this or not, but it makes sense to me, but an earthly shepherd is also called to protect the sheep from diseases. Like other animals, sheep are susceptible to diseases. Shepherds are often responsible for minor injuries or basic medical treatment. Basic medical treatment. That means that they know only so much. Now, the Lord provides medical treatment, but it's in such a bigger way. Matthew 4:23 says, Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in other synagogues, proclaiming good news from the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness among the people. Luke 4:40 says, at sunset, the people brought to Jesus all who had various kinds of sickness, and laying his hands on each one, he healed them. Luke 5:15, yet the news about him spread all through all the more. So the crowds of people came to hear him and to be healed of their sicknesses. Now, here's that statement I said I was going to make throughout this teaching tonight. It says the Lord will protect, provide, directs, leads, and cares for his people. He directs. Isaiah 48:17 says, this is what the Lord says, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord your God who teaches you what is best for you, who directs you in the way you should go. Proverbs 16:9 says, in their hearts, humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps. Now, what did David say in Psalm 23 that I read earlier? He said, the Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside quiet waters. He cares. 1 Peter 5:7 says, cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. Psalms 55:22 says, cast your cares on the Lord and he will sustain you. He will never let the righteous be shaken. In the book of Revelation, John has a vision and he sees so many different things. He sees creatures, horses, angels, the throne of heaven. He even sees the seals, and at one point he starts to cry, he starts to weep, and he looks around and says, is anyone worthy? And I believe it was an angel that said, don't cry. He starts to tell him Jesus is going to open the seals. He's worthy. But the part that I'm getting ready to read to you is where John actually sees a great multitude of white robes. And this is what he says in Revelation 7:9. He says, after this, I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, tribe, people, and language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. And they cried out in a loud voice, salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb. All the angels were standing around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They fell down on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, amen. Praise and glory and wisdom and thanks and honor and power and strength be to our God. Forever and ever. Amen. Then one of the elders asked me, these in white robes, who are they and where did they come from? I answered, sir, you know. And he said, these are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore, they are before the throne of God and serve him day and night in his temple. And he who sits on the throne will shelter them with his presence. Never again will they hunger. Never again will they thirst. The sun will not beat down on them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd. He will lead them to the springs of living water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. The Lord protects, provides, directs, leads, and cares for his people. God tenderly takes care of us as a strong and patient shepherd. Hebrews 13:20 says, now may the God of peace, who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back from the dead, our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing his will, and may he work in us what is pleasing to him through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. So tonight was about Jehovah Rohi, the Lord is my shepherd. He is our shepherd. He leads us. He guides us. He directs us. He protects us. He cares for us. And there's so much more in scripture that pertains to what he does, how he heals the sick, how he gives us good things, how he's always taking our burdens, how he's always leading and directing us, how he just loves us. Thank you for joining us. I hope that this gave you more insight in regards to God, Jehovah Rohi being our shepherd. And I hope that you take this into your spirit and make it personal. The Lord is my shepherd. He is my shepherd. All right. I will see you next Thursday at 7 p.m. for more of Daughters of the King. Have a good one.